Cassiopeia region. Cassiopeia is very close to Polaris, and it looks like a chair. And you know, there is a story about a queen sitting in a chair, and she kind of rotates around that Polaris. It's a beautiful story. I want you to read about it. Part Nebula and actually Sol Nebula, they are pretty close to each other, and they are located around that Polaris region and near the Cassiopeia, inside the Cassiopeia region. Both are emission nebulas. Emission nebulas meaning there is ionized hydrogen, H alpha or hydrogen alpha or HA. Primarily, there is a heart inside the heart nebula. It contains several stars that are like 50 times mass of our sun. There are some stars that are like really a fraction of our sun. Today is actually almost close to a full moon day, so I'm using the monochrome camera. So it's actually like in a black and white, that's how you can think of. But when you put a H alpha filter, the hydrogen alpha filter, also called HA filter, in this one, it takes only that spectrum of light, that band of the light, and it ignores the rest of them. So that's the beauty of it. And I wanted to combine that with LRGB. The red, green and blue filters, generally they have a IR and UV blocks on them, so I might not catch that much of a moon glow. So that's the plan. I hope it works and I can see the love in the sky. I'll show you my workflow. So I took flats for each of the filters. I took two types of flats, 24K and 20K. I ended up using 20K filters. 24K, I was afraid it might wash out completely. Also created folder structure on the external hard drive, the HA, the red, green, blue and all, to make sure that I save the files in the right spot when I'm ready. I took HA pictures for 125 pictures for almost like an hour. They came out okay. Similarly, I took the red, green, blue 30 seconds as well. And I think I took 65 pictures for each one of them. Processing in PixInsight for LRGB images didn't turn out to be that simple. So once I moved the stacked pictures from Deep Sky Stacker, for some reason the PixInsight didn't work very well. So I have to stack again in PixInsight. And once I stacked them, I used the split RGB channels, pulled out the appropriate either red or green or blue, depends on what the channel it is, and then I combined them. Once I combined them, I had another problem. You see those cons, like, you know, the circles, they are just the duplicate stars, so basically they didn't align properly, so I had to use the star alignment. Star alignment only can be done on the nonlinear images. And also you have to use a reference image. So I used HA image as a reference and fixed the remaining three images based on HA. As you notice when you see the file, it actually adjusted. That's why it is kind of showing the black thing on the top. So it actually fixed the frame. So the original image looks like this on the left. On the right side, once the star aligned, you see a little bit of angle on the top. That's what the problem was. And it actually fixed the similar images, similarly the remaining images. And you see, you know, the different channels, how they got stacked. Now the image looks good. I combined the H alpha image using the NRGB combination. So I selected the RGB and then also I selected the HA. Using the NRGB combination, if you click on the NRGB button, you get the file basically after the combination. Here is the file that is after the combine. I did a dynamic crop to clean up the image, and also there is quite a bit of noise pollution. I used ACDNR script. It worked really well.
I used just the defaults. I used both the luminance and the chrominance from here. And once I performed that function, I have a cleaned up image. Here is the cleaned up image. It looks pretty good. Also, I did the histogram transformation. You see that I moved the curve to the left, to the right a little bit, so that the background gets a little darker. And then I also did the curves transformation. I put an S-curve on it. Here is my final picture. I hope you guys like it. Thanks for watching.
Burning.